إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد أيها الإخوة المؤمنون أيها الإخوة الصائمون يا أحباب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام الحمد لله على نعمة رمضان الحمد لله وقد بقيت ليلة 27 and 29 من شهر رمضان. Still, we have a great opportunity to conclude the month of Ramadan in a beautiful way. Still, the night of 27th of Ramadan to come, and the night of 29th of Ramadan to come, and the day of Al-Jaiza, the day of the wages, the day of the gifts, يوم العيد, عيد الفطر to come, where all the forgiveness and all the acceptance for all the hard work in the month of Ramadan. Brothers and sisters, we need to not to forget the importance of the end of Ramadan and السبع البواقي, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تحروها في السبع البواقي, the last 7 days of Ramadan. And Laylatul Qadr, try to catch it and experience it in these nights. We should not actually be distracted by looking at the Eid and Eid arrangement. So many people, they are talking now about the Eid. And we leave the main focus, which is Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alf shahr. Inshallah ta'ala also, we need to concentrate in these days about what will happen in our life after Ramadan. Are we going to continue with the good a'mal and good khair and good barakah and good deeds? Or we are going to go back to our old style and bad habits? Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are many narrations. One is a question from Aisha radiallahu anha. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this statement, that Allah loves the consistent good deeds, even if it is little. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَدْوَمُ الْأَعْمَالِ وَإِنْ قَلْ. So if you do little, better than you work hard in Ramadan and leave 11 months without any work, even little. What that mean? أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ. Consistent and even little. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said, even little, which means صدقة every day, £1 every day, or £5 every Friday. You come to the masjid, you give صدقة, and through the year, that's consistent, and even if it is little. It's much better and beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from sadaqah once off, even if it is big sadaqah. Just think in that way. A person min qiyamul layl for 1 month, taraweeh, qiyam layl, tahajjud, and then the whole year doesn't do anything. No, the person who does qiyamul layl every night, two rak'ah, is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what we do in Ramadan, we increase the good deeds. After Ramadan, even if it is decreased, but should not be stopped. Even 2 rak'ah, even 1 pound sadaqah, dua, people make lots of dua in Ramadan. After Ramadan, we should continue with dua. Even little. Even you make dua, رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبُّنَا صِغَارًا, for our parents. We should not forget this all the year. 2 rak'ah qiyamul layl, 1 pound sadaqah, dua, Read the Quran. This Quran should not go back to the shelf again. But the Quran should continue. Even if every prayer, after every prayer, you read one ayah. One ayah. Five ayat. Five prayers a day. When you wake up in the morning, you read half page or one page. Before you sleep, you read one page. It takes from you 1 or 2 or 3 minutes. This is the deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So we need to think of a strategy. What are these little deeds that we are going to continue with after Ramadan so we become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our situation and condition after Ramadan become much better than before Ramadan. Also, we need to plan fasting the 6th of Shawwal. 6 days of Shawwal, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Whoever fasted Ramadan and followed that with 6 days of Shawwal, this considered as if the person fasted the whole year. And if you do it every year, as if in another narration, you fasted the whole dahr, the whole umr, the whole life. Why? Because Ramadan multiplied to 10. You get reward of 10 months. And the 6 days multiply 10 to 60 days. So that's 2 months. 2 months and 10 months, that's the 12 months of the year. So you get the reward of fasting of the whole year. Look at this Muslim ummah. Allah bless this Muslim ummah that they do little deeds, but they get multiplied rewards. Other ummah before us used to do lots of good deeds, and they will be considered as one single deed. Subhanallah. Brothers in Islam, also need to help each other and look after our community. This is very important. And look after our masjid and our people around us. The widow, the orphans, the shaheed's families, and the poor families, people of vulnerability, and people of special needs. Old people, they should get the care and respect. Young people, they should get the guidance and help and encouragement and inspiration and love from everyone in the community. We should look after our ladies, our mothers, our wives, our daughters, our sisters, our aunties, our grandmothers in the society. So we look after them because this is the key success, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Nusurtum bidu'afaikum." If we look after the weak one among us, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the power and strength and success. Also, I would like to remind myself and everyone about Sadaqatul Fitr, Zakatul Fitr, Fitrana, for those one who didn't give Sadaqatul Fitr, to hasten and do it, because the time becomes shorter and shorter for the due day and the due time for it. And we should pay it as early as possible. And nowadays, it's paid online. You can pay it through abardeenmosque.org online, easy. And that will give us opportunity to transfer this to the charities where they buy food and parcels to help the poor on the day of Eid and make them feel good, as it is the main purpose of Sadaqatul Fitr, to look after the poor on the day of Eid. Brothers and sisters, make the day of Eid a special day. Make it a special day because Allah wanted it to be special. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it special. Because the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they made it special. And this is very important for us. So we make it special at home. Change the routine. Change the atmosphere. There is Salatul Eid. And there are children. Some people booked for Salatul Eid. Alhamdulillah, the masjid will accommodate 500 people in the Eid day. This is small masjid, because 6 prayers of Eid, inshallah, they are going to take place. May Allah bless all the organizers and all the attendees, inshallah. Brothers in Islam, 6 prayers of Eid, we want them to be safe and organize them well. So people need to observe the 2-meter distance and the mask and all this. We need to look after our community very well. Some people, they have health conditions, but they don't reveal this. Maybe they are next to us. So we need to be careful protecting ourselves, but also protecting others. Outside the masjid, we don't want the crowd on the day of Eid. And inshallah, the masjid is going to look after the congregation and make sure that everyone looked after, inshallah ta'ala. Brothers, also on the day of Eid, you need to eat before leaving for Eid. So you eat date, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to eat tamarat, some dates before you leave. That's the sunnah, because this is Eid al-Fitr. Fitr means iftar. Fitr means ta'am, means food. So you eat. It's not fasting, the opposite of fasting. You cannot leave the house without eating something. That's the sunnah. You eat something, even drink water. And do the takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. And you wear the newest clothes that you have. And have nice shower. And leave, inshallah, with happiness to the Eid. And go back from another road so you can greet more people. And the malaika greet you and make dua for you. And show the power of Islam as well. And help more people and smile to more people. Brothers in Islam, the Eid maybe on Wednesday or maybe on Thursday. Wednesday the 12th and Thursday the 13th. So please follow the Aberdeen Mosque and Islamic Center website and social media to get the announcement of the Hilal of Eid. The Hilal of Eid, the moon sighting of Eid, inshaAllah ta'ala. And Salatul Eid will be inside the masjid this year due to the current situation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this Eid a special Eid for all the Muslim Ummah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of us and all our good deeds. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alam. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله وبعد. Brothers in Islam, inshallah ta'ala, our focus should be in the coming generation. We need to preserve the iman in their heart by the will of Allah and help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. The condition of certain people will not change unless until they change it by themselves. So we need really to look after our young one and talk to them always about Iman, about Allah, about Taqwa, about the Deen, and make sure our houses, houses of Noor. Not the screen, big screen, running. We don't want to enter Muslim houses and see this big screen and then girls are just dancing half naked in the screen. This is not Muslim house. Practice. Muslim house practice where Islamic channel there, Islamic channels, where Quran, where the ta'aleem, where there are actually lecturers and good deeds are there. When there is halaqat, when there is a place in the masjid, one of the rooms or part of a room, they allocated as masjid of the house. Where the family gather for the Quran to read to each other every day as they gather for food. And see, this is very important even to do joint projects and family projects together. We want to look after our communities virtually and look after their deen and taqwa, remind each other, help each other. If you see somebody young, mashallah, tabarakallah, Allah ibarak, encourage people, encourage young generation, because they have so many challenges to come in their life. And they need to be strong in terms of their iman. We know our time. We know the challenge that we have in this era. But we don't know the challenges that the Muslim Ummah having in the next era. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the authentic hadith, in the last time before the Qiyamah, every year will be worse than the year before in terms of challenging for the Muslim Ummah. So we need to look after our children. Make them empowered with knowledge, with qualification, with training, with skills, with Iman, with Taqwa, with knowledge of Islam, with knowledge of Quran, with knowledge of Sunnah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah, this is our mission, should be inshallah ta'ala. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد أمين. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم أمين. إنك حميد مجيد أمين. اللهم أعنا على أنفسنا بفعل الطاعات أمين. وترك المنكرات أمين. اللهم أحينا مسلمين وتوفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك ثواب ليلة القدر يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا فيها من الفائزين، واجعلنا فيها من المقبولين، واجعلنا فيها من المرحومين، واجعلنا فيها من المعتوقين. اللهم يا ربنا نسألك لوالدينا سؤالا خاصا، اللهم ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم إن كان منهم حيا فأطل في عمره واحسن عمله واحسن ختامه يا رب العالمين. ومن كان منهم ميتا اللهم إنا نسألك لهم الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين. يا ربنا ويا حبيبنا نسألك أن تجعلنا من عتقاء شهر رمضان. اللهم اعتق رقابنا ووالدينا من النار. اللهم اجعل تفرق اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع جمعا مرحوما، واجعل تفرقنا من بعده معصوما ومرحوما يا رب العالمين. ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا لا شقيا ولا محروما برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.